Okay, this is definitely the world's hardest music theory test.
Hello, do you want to introduce yourself
first? Yeah, hi, my name is Terence.
I'm Jeslyn.
My name is James.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how confident are you in your music theory skills?
1.
I think I'll go for a 6.
I have a grade 5 in music theory, but how does it translate, I'm not sure.
Alright, so Terence, today you will be attempting the hardest music theory quiz you will ever take.
Okay.
How do you feel about that?
Yeah, not really confident about it.
Is it certified hardest?
A few moments later.
Okay, this is definitely the world's hardest music theory test.
Okay, there are 20 questions. How well do you think
you will do? I think I'll do 4 out of 20.
Maybe 6 to 8.
I don't know the questions yet, but maybe 5? 5 out of 20, that's about 25%.
Alright, so glance through the questions and let us know how you feel about the questions.
Oh, it's objective.
Oh, it's from ClassicFM. Definitely the hardest music theory quiz you will ever take. I think this is clickbait, but we'll see.
Okay, you may begin with question 1.
Okay, first question. Describe the indicated interval.
The octave is definitely more than 8, so it has to be an augmented 11 or a perfect 11.
That's augmented. That's perfect. 11.
ABCDEF.
Yay!
It looks like this. Okay, adjust this. Oh, so sad.
Okay, oh, it's augmented 11. Okay. Okay, I was confident it was going to be augmented 11, but it turns out the answer is perfect 11. Why, huh?
So you have reached the midway point of the quiz. How long do you think you've done so far?
I think it will be more than 5.
But only 1 correct so far?
I'm pretty. What kind of score will you get by the end of the quiz?
Or maybe 2.
The note F when written for alto flute
will sound as which note?
Alto flute is not a common instrument I've seen.
If I'm not mistaken, I think alto flute is like a perfect fifth above or below the actual note.
Alto flute got different with normal flute?
Since it requires transposing, I don't think it would be an F.
Okay, so it's F. If it's below, it's B flat. There's no B flats here. So I'm gonna go for F, G, A, B. I'm gonna go for C. Correct.
I'll just go for a C. Okay.
I'll just simply choose 1. Okay, never mind.
What is wrong with this music written for tenor trombone?
Tenor trombone is what we normally see, right?
What's a tenor trombone?
There's insufficient opportunity for the player to breathe. I mean, if it's fast, do you have to breathe?
Too fast to play. I think trombone player can handle fast pace.
Vivace. What?
Okay, so I'm gonna go for the glissando is impossible. Correct.
Yeah.
I think it's impossible.
So what's your final score?
8 out of 20. Okay, I did better than expected.
7.
And I got 16 out of 20.
I think this is very niche knowledge of like the music theory. So even though you have grade 8, okay, maybe if you have like high level of music theory, then maybe you can get some of this.
I didn't use much of my music theory knowledge. It's more of my luck. Yeah.
Most of it, I don't understand. I just somehow got it correct.
What do you think your music teachers, your band directors would think about your
result? I don't think they'll be proud because I'm just shooting all my answers.
Go back and relearn your theory from grad 1.
Honestly, I don't think they taught me this. So even if I fail, I think they're okay with it.
Alright, send a message to your viewers. Would you like them to challenge?
Maybe not challenge, but I would definitely encourage people to try this. And then if you get it wrong, try to find out why. So it's like a process of learning.
Go give this quiz a try and let's see if you can beat my score, 16 out of 20.
Come, don't challenge me, but challenge it, man.
Thank you so much for watching this episode. If you'd like for us to cover more content like this, let us know in the comment section down below. Until then, stay safe.